morning and welcome to the Worship Center. I'm so pleased we can be together to worship God and to hear one of God's special stories. Let's greet one another. The Lord be with you. And you say, and also with you. I trust you've all had a really good week and been able to manage school okay and just been having some fun and perhaps being outside a little bit. Let's get ready for a story. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. I wonder if this is a parable. Parables are very precious, like gold. And this box is gold. It looks like a present. Sometimes parables are like presents. They've already been given to us. You can't buy them, you can't steal them. They're already ours. There's another reason why this might be a parable. It has a lid. And it seems sometimes parables have lids. And when you open the lid of a parable, there's something very precious inside. I know. Let's open the lid and see. I wonder what this could be. It's quite rough. I wonder what could be so rough. It's very brown. I wonder where such a brown place could be. I wonder what this could be. Put one end here, the other end there. I wonder what it could be. Let's see if there's anything else that could help us. There are these. Once there was someone who said amazing things and did such wonderful things that people began to follow him. One day, a lawyer asked, "What is the most important law?" And he answered him, "You already know." And the lawyer said, "We are to love God and our neighbor." "But who is our neighbor?" And he told a parable. There was a traveler going down the road from Jerusalem to Jericho. Robbers came and attacked him and hurt him and took everything he had and left him on the side of the road, half dead. A priest from the temple in Jerusalem was coming down the road. When he saw him, He passed by on the other side. A Levite, who also worked in the temple, was going down the road. When he saw him, he passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, who was not even from the same country, was traveling down the road. When he came to where he was, he saw him, and he had compassion. And he went to him, and he put medicine and bandages on his sores, and put him on his donkey, and took him to the inn. And he stayed with him the whole night. And he told the innkeeper that the man could stay there until he was well, and he would pay for all of it. Which one of these, the priest, the Levite, and the Samaritan, which one was a neighbor to the person who was hurt and left on the side of the road? I wonder if the person on the side of the road, I wonder if he has a name. I wonder where this road is really going. I wonder who was a neighbor to the robbers. I wonder who was a neighbor to the priest. I wonder who is a neighbor to the Levite. And I wonder who was a neighbor to the Samaritan. I wonder how the Samaritan could be a neighbor. I'm going to read from the Bible now. But before I do that, I'm going to light the Christ candle. This reminds us that God is with us, wherever we may be, wherever we may go. Our Bible reading comes from Luke 10, verses 25 to 37. A teacher of the law came up and tried to trap Jesus. "Teacher," he asked, "what must I do to receive eternal life?" And Jesus answered him, "What do the scriptures say? How do you interpret them?" The man answered, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as you love yourself." "You are right," Jesus replied. "Do this and you will live." But the teacher of the law wanted to justify himself, so he asked, "Who is my neighbor?" Jesus answered, "There was a man who was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho, when robbers attacked him, stripped him, and beat him up, leaving him half dead. It so happened that a priest was going down the road, but when he saw the man, he walked on by on the other side. In the same way, a Levite also came there, went over and looked at the man, and then walked by on the other side. But a Samaritan who was traveling that way came upon the man, and when he saw him, his heart was filled with pity. He went over to him, poured oil and wine on his wounds, and bandaged them. And then he put the man on his own animal and took him to the inn where he took care of him. The next day he took out 2 shilling coins and gave them to the innkeeper. Take care of him, he told the innkeeper, and when you come back this way, I will pay you whatever else you spend on him. And Jesus concluded, in your opinion, which one of these three acted like a neighbor toward the man attacked by the robbers? The teacher of the law answered, the one who was kind to him. And Jesus replied, you go then and do the same. This is our time to say our prayers and thanksgivings. So perhaps at partway through the prayer time, you could say a prayer, perhaps something that you're thankful for, or maybe somebody that you'd like to say a prayer for. So I will start. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We pray for all the children and their families. We pray that you'll be keeping them safe and well. And thank you for the story today that we heard, learning how to be a good neighbor. Help us to remember that every day. And this is a time where you can say your prayer. Dear Father, we thank you for this time that we've had together in the worship center. Bless all of the children and their families, and bring us back together here again next week. We pray this in your name. Amen. Let's say our goodbye song together. Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go. So I'm going to change the light now. Mind that God can be with us wherever we go. Blessings to you all. Have a great week and look forward to seeing you next week.